Japan airliner crash in the hopes that they may provide clues as to why the jet crashed on Monday. Today, they recovered both the flight data and cockpit voice recorders. As well, they found the jet's right rear door, something that the pilot reported having problems with just before the crash. While the investigation continues, some 136 bodies have been pulled from the wreckage. In all, 520 people died in the disaster. Japan Airlines president has offered to resign. Canada has sent an investigator to the crash site. Officials are hoping to find new leads into the still unsolved Air India jet crash in June. At the moment, the only obvious similarity is that the two crashes involved 747s. Canadian experts have few leads into the Air India disaster. In Beirut, at least 10 people were killed and more than 100 wounded when a powerful car bomb exploded in Christian East Beirut today. The blast also damaged 6 apartment buildings and set dozens of cars on fire. Beirut police estimate that nearly 200 kilograms of dynamite were packed into the sedan. They don't yet know who set it off. And the animal rights group Life Force has withdrawn charges against 2 University of Western Ontario researchers. The researchers had been accused of cruelty to animals because of an experiment involving a baboon. But Life Force spokesmen say they've received word that the university has stopped the experiment and would no longer use the controversial animal restraining device. I'll have more news at 11 o'clock.
Another great season on Global. Wednesdays, old Skip and Harry are at it again.
Excuse me, I'm Henry Fish.
The outrageous new action comedy series, Stir Crazy, takes off in the hit movie and never looks back.
You are now united.
Who will survive the massacre in Moldavia? Will Valine recover her stolen twins? Even more surprises are in store for 86 on Dynasty and Knots Landing. Share the excitement of another great season Wednesdays. Another great season on Global. Thursdays, your weekly Wintario draw with Faye and Greg moves to a new time. From the creators of Dynasty, a spellbinding new offspring, Dynasty 2, The Colby, stars Emma Sams and John James.
Daddy, where's Mommy?
And it's back, the Emmy-winning Hill Street Blues, on the roll and on the prowl. Share the excitement of another great season Thursdays. Global's really got it. Faye Dance and Greg Beresford host Wintario with a grand prize of $200,000. Tomorrow at 9 on the Global Television Network. Watch Mike Andre on News Center 2. This is the NBC Television Network. NBC, let's all be
there. Heartbeat will continue.
Sunday, Hunter shopping for a killer.
I just dropped by to give you guys a lesson.
But Rick's a little steamed when a dirty cop's on the case.
This guy's a one-man killing machine.
You better shut him down or all the pretty girls will die Sunday.
That works for me.
From News Center 2, here's Susan Banks.
Good evening. It was a short haul for car haulers. Their not quite three-week-long strike is close to ending and new cars could be delivered again soon. The busing battle in West Seneca swung into high gear tonight, and it was Buffalo mayoral candidates night. Ed Caldwell will have a report. All at 11 on News Center 2.
Watch Wayne Hartung on News Center 2.
We have a terrific show for you tonight. We have Pee Wee Herman, Betty White, Roddy McDowell, and Olympic champion Mary Lou Retton. So watch us tonight. It's going to be a great show.
Thank you.
Thursday on Cheers, Carla's old ex shows Sam some new tricks.
So much to learn from this man.
Then on Night Court, Billy scores on a new romance, but Harry's got her number. And on Hill Street Blues, can a distraught father be stopped from making a fatal mistake?
Prepare to assault. Thursday.
New cars could be rolling into the area soon. The candidates get to speak out, and two brothers find each other after years of being apart.
Time now for an editorial with WIVB-TV President and General Manager Leslie G. Aries.
We wonder where the world would be today had the development of nuclear arms been decided in the arena of public opinion. If the Manhattan Project had been debated in the Congress rather than carried forth in secret, the delays might have given the Axis powers time to finish their tests, and the first atomic bombs might have exploded over London, Moscow, or New York City. We might all be living under the rule of fascist leaders, and the technological superiority we enjoy might reside in an all-powerful Nazi Germany. While that scenario is not probable, there can be little doubt that we have benefited tremendously over the last 40 years as a result of our nuclear superiority. While the nuclear deterrent is not an ideal tool to maintain world peace, only a fool would suggest that the alternatives would be better. So it is with Star Wars. What choice do we have? Allow a totalitarian state to develop a defense system that might neutralize our nuclear weapons? How foolish. That would doom the world to eons of slavery. Star Wars is scary, but it's the only chance we have to maintain world peace.
Stay alive. Don't drink and drive.
Saturday night has it. At 7, it's Dance Fever, and the contest's hotter than ever. Then at 7:30, it's the songs they're dancing to on America's Top 10. Join Casey Kasem for music videos and the countdown to all your favorites. Catch them both Saturday nights, Dance Fever at 7 and America's Top 10 at 7:30, right here on Channel 4.
The nighttime price is right.
A new station wagon, $25,000 in cash. A new sports.
That's right. It's a nighttime Price is Right with host Tom Kennedy. 7:30 weeknights right here.
Dennis is the winner.
Join us for the nighttime Price is Right. 7:30 weeknights on Channel 4. It's a new time and a great time with the new $25,000 pyramid now at 10:30. Every weekday morning, Dick Clark hosts contestants for a battle of wits against each other and against the clock. The winnings get bigger, and the excitement climbs towards the $25,000 jackpot. Move along with the Emmy Award-winning $25,000 pyramid. Now at its new time, 10:30, following Sally Jesse Raphael. Weekday mornings on Channel 4.
You first. How is this doing wonderful things for your marriage, that you go and sleep with other people?
Well, I think before...
No, not you!
I got a crush on Burt Reynolds. He's tall and he's dark and he's handsome and he's a good actor and he's funny and he has a lot of sex appeal.
And I ended up like kissing the window and the door, and I was so embarrassed afterwards I still thanked her for it.
Sally Jesse Raphael, 10 a.m. weekdays on Channel 4.
The 40 Plus Club of Buffalo, a nonprofit self-help employment organization, has been established to serve 8 counties of western New York and southern Ontario. Its objective is to help unemployed managers, executives, and professionals 40 or older to conduct an effective job search campaign. For more information about membership, call 856-0491.
America's Top 10, Saturday at 7:30.
This is the CTV Television Network.
The A-Team. Catch the special 2-hour season premiere Tuesday at 8 p.m.
This is the CTV Television Network.
September 28th at 8 p.m.